Hey guys, in this video I will show you the correct way of trading and taking signals with the Awesome Oscillator. The Awesome Oscillator is a momentum indicator and it measures the momentum of the last 5 bars compared to its momentum in the last 34 bars. So, the Awesome Oscillator indicates if the bulls or the bears are in control of the market. The indicator is plotted as a histogram and is used to confirm the trends and to determine the possible cycle's turning points. Here's how I personally read the Awesome Oscillator. The oscillator above the zero line forming a peak signals a bullish trend. The oscillator below the zero line forming a peak signals a bearish trend. The oscillator crossing the zero line from below indicates a bullish momentum, and the oscillator crossing the zero line from upward indicates a bearish momentum. Here's how you should take signals with the Awesome Oscillator. The first setup is called the zero line cross. The zero line cross is one of the most common strategies used by traders when using the Awesome Oscillator. The rules are pretty simple. When the Awesome Oscillator crosses above the zero line, this means that the short-term momentum is rising faster than the long-term momentum, indicating a buying pressure. And when the Awesome Oscillator crosses below the zero line, this means that the short-term momentum is decreasing faster than the long-term momentum, indicating a selling pressure. I prefer to filter the zero line cross with an exponential moving average for a better confirmation of the main trend on the market. As you can observe in this Bitcoin chart on the 1 hour time frame, this setup offered two valid signals when the Awesome Oscillator crossed below the zero line. Let's analyze another chart, this time the Dow Jones index on the 1 hour time frame. As we can see, the Awesome Oscillator generated three solid buy signals. With a proper money management and a trailing stop, traders could capture some decent price movements by using this strategy. As most of the indicators, the Awesome Oscillator works even better when the market is in a trend mode. The second Awesome Oscillator setup is called the Twin Peaks. For this setup to offer a valid signal, the market needs several conditions to be met. First, two consecutive peaks must be formed above the zero line for a sell entry, or below the zero line for a buy entry. Also, the second peak must be lower than the first one and must be followed by a red bar for a sell entry, and must be higher than the first peak and followed by a green line for a buy entry. Also, the body between the peaks stays above the zero line for a sell signal and below the zero line for a buy signal. This setup resembles a lot with the divergence between the price and the Awesome Oscillator. Very important, this setup is not suitable for trend following traders. In this Bitcoin chart, we can see that all the conditions were met. The Awesome Oscillator formed two peaks in a strong upward trend, with the second one being lower than the first one. Also, the Awesome Oscillator stayed above the zero line, and the red bar appeared on the Awesome Oscillator, signaling a switch in momentum. Now here's the thing, the setup will offer many false signals, so we must confirm it with other tools. In this example, a conservative entry was generated when the price breached the lower trend line of the upward trend and retested it. Thus, the previous support became resistance and we were safe to enter the short side. On the Dow Jones index on the 1 hour time frame, a twin peaks configuration occurred during a strong downward trend. We filtered the signal with the same method used before. We waited for the price to close above the upward trend line of the downward channel. you can also observe that the Awesome Oscillator moved into positive territory, crossing the zero line, which is another confirmation that the market momentum switched to the upside. The third setup with the Awesome Oscillator is called Saucers. This strategy tracks the short-term changes in the momentum and requires a pattern in three consecutive bars of the Awesome Oscillator. Three bars must be on the positive side or on the negative side of the zero line, and a red bar followed by a smaller red bar followed by a green bar indicates a bullish saucer, and a green bar followed by a smaller green bar followed by a red bar indicates a bearish saucer. This strategy works well when we trade only in the direction of the main trend. Best way to do this is to add a 200 exponential moving average and take only buy signals if the price trades above the 200 EMA and only sell signals if the price trades below the 200 EMA. Here's another example on this DAX index chart. Here we have a bullish saucer with a red bar followed by a smaller red bar followed by a green bar. Also, here's a bearish saucer with a green bar followed by a smaller green bar followed by a red bar. All in all, the Awesome Oscillator can be a valuable tool which can generate quality signals when used correctly and in combination with other tools. If you got any value from this, please consider subscribing to our channel and give a like to this video, as it would help us massively in the future. Until next time.